Last week, I talked about adding the Plugadget 2.5-inch mounting bracket PC card to my file server. I'll be switching from FreeNAS on mirrored USB flash drives to TrueNAS CORE on mirrored SSDs in 6 steps. Since my motherboard has a legacy BIOS, step 4 took a lot longer than it should have. The first step is to download the FreeNAS config file from my file server. With the FreeNAS GUI in the web browser, I click on System, General, and then the Save Config button. I click on the boxes for Export Password Secret Seed and Export Pool Encryption Keys in the dialog box. I save the config file to the download folder on my editing PC. The second step is to remove the USB flash drives. I shut down the system, pulled out the 8GB SanDisk Cruzer Fit USB flash drives, and put them aside for safekeeping. If I don't upgrade the GFX storage pool on my hard drives, I can always plug in the USB flash drives and boot up FreeNAS. After I'm confident that TrueNAS is working fine, I'll update the GFX storage pool. The third step is to install the SSDs. I installed a pair of ADATA 120GB SSDs into the new 2.5-inch mounting bracket PC cards. The smallest SSD recommended for a TrueNAS boot drive is 16GB. Smaller SSDs cost about the same as a 120GB SSD at $20 or so. Since the motherboard is a micro ATX, I installed the PC cards in the empty bottom slots. I needed 4 cables for my junk box, the Molex power cable for the Seasonic 620-watt modular power supply, a Molex to SATA power splitter, a pair of SATA data cables with straight connectors. SATA port 0 through 3 were difficult to access behind the SAS and power cables for the hard drives. I plugged the data cables into port 4 and 5 on the motherboard since they were more accessible. All the cables got tucked away into the bundle at the bottom of the case and behind the hard drives. The fourth step is to fiddle with the legacy BIOS to recognize the new SSDs. When I booted up the system, the BIOS couldn't find the SSDs and tried to boot one of the hard drives. I forgot that I turned off the SATA ports in the BIOS after I installed the SAS control card 2 years ago. I turned on the SATA ports in the BIOS and rebooted the system. That didn't work either. After a couple of hours of fiddling around with the BIOS, I pulled the CMOS battery and reloaded the defaults for the BIOS. This time the BIOS screen found the SSDs. I booted the USB flash drive with the TrueNAS Core installer. The fifth step is installing TrueNAS Core onto the SSDs. After I selected the SSDs at mirrored boot drives, I got prompted to upgrade the install or do a fresh install. I had installed TrueNAS on the SSDs for my test PC as a test run. I selected fresh install. The next screen asked if I wanted to upgrade the boot environment or reformat the drive. I selected to reformat the SSDs. I got prompted to enter the root password. The final screen prompted if I wanted to boot via UEFI or the BIOS. I selected boot via the BIOS. The installer did a thing. When I got prompted to remove the USB stick, I rebooted the file server. The sixth step is to upload the FreeNAS config file. I pointed my web browser to the IP address that the file server booted up with and log into the web-based GUI. I click on System, General, and the Upload Config button. I uploaded the FreeNAS config file and rebooted the file server. The settings migration from FreeNAS to TrueNAS didn't take long since I had a very simple setup. I didn't have any containers, jails, or virtual machines. When the file server came back up, everything behaved as if it was still running FreeNAS. That's it for today's show. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and turn on the notification bell to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching.